Number 104, One More Christmas Hero. Welcome. I like to think of the spirit of Christmas warming my heart all year long because I can relate so clearly to the warmth of Christmas. I love stories of service, which are wonderful all year long, but so very to the point at Christmas time. Here's another Christmas storm story.
Concerns about melting snow in western New York after that crippling blizzard. The death toll from the storm has now climbed to 40, 31 in Buffalo alone. But amidst the grief, we're also hearing stories of heroism. News 4's Adam Harding is live in Buffalo with a TV exclusive about one man's efforts, incredible efforts to save lives. Adam?
And Gilma, this turned into a remarkable story of survival. Within the hour, we just spoke with the man who says he was in his car with strangers. They had run out of gas. They had no other options. They saw a school nearby, so they broke a window and made their way in to stay alive. Police releasing surveillance video because they knew that this person did all he could to help strangers. The question is, who was he? The mystery began with a handwritten note, an apology for breaking a window at a Cheektowaga school last Friday. Got stuck at 8 p.m., it reads. Slept in my truck with two strangers, just trying not to die. There were seven elderly people also stuck and out of fuel. I had to do it to save everyone. It ends with Merry Christmas, Jay. It was at the height of the deadliest blizzard in Buffalo's history. Police Thursday releasing this surveillance photo of the mystery man, not because he was in any trouble, but to instead highlight his actions to go above and beyond. Investigators pleading for the public's help in tracking him down. And we did. With whom do I have the pleasure of speaking?
Jay Withy.
Jay says he was out of options. He was frozen.
Just survival. You know, you just got to think of others, and you know, I'm not thinking of myself only. I'm thinking of Mary, and I'm thinking of Mike, and I'm thinking there has to be other people in the area that are stuck.
Photos from the school security system show a group sitting in the cafeteria. Police say they got food, but only ate enough to stay alive.
I got cereal, water, juice, apples, and I put on the cafeteria table for them to eat. And I ate something quick, and I drank something quick, and out I went to go look for more people, and I walked and I walked and I walked till I cried. I couldn't walk anymore.
His selfless act now being recognized by the department. The worst of times bringing out the best in this community.
I left the school with people still in it because they were out of power at Christmas Sunday at 8 p.m.
So you spent Christmas?
Christmas Eve and Christmas most of Christmas Day.
At the school?
Correct.
With these strangers?
With strangers.
What'd you guys talk about?
Everything and how thankful we are, and you know, just you know, the different meanings of Christmas now. Anything I took, I left a note on, but I left a note for mostly the whole school, you know, telling them I'm sorry if there's any charges that have to be paid, or you know, if I have to pay for a window, if I have to pay for some food, that so be it. But
you're alive.
But I'm alive, and so we're end up totaling 24 people.
How do you feel?
Very humbled. Very humbled.
They are just built differently here in Buffalo, especially at the worst of times. It is remarkable to see.
I think for every noble act of kindness, there are angels present. May we all find ample opportunity to serve and be guided to where we are most useful. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Merry Christmas.